problem, we're asked to find the general solution for this differential equation. This differential equation is linear differential equations of the second order with constant coefficient. To find the general solution of the equation of this type, we need to solve firstly the characteristic equation. So the characteristic equation for this differential equation will be lambda squared because of the second derivative of y plus 3 lambda because of the first derivative of y, and plus 2 equals 0. And we need to find the roots of this quadratic equation. This quadratic equation we can write as lambda plus 2 times lambda plus 1 equals 0. And therefore, the roots of this quadratic equation is simple. So lambda will be minus 2 and minus 1. So this is the first root of the characteristic equation, and this is the second one. Solution for the root minus 2 will be of the form e to the power minus 2x. And solution corresponding to the second root of the characteristic equation will be e to the power minus x. And therefore, the general solution of this differential equation will be the linear combination of these two. So the general solution will be some constant a multiplied by the first function here, and plus another constant b multiplied by the second function. And here's given the general solution of the equation given to us. That's all. So, as in the preceding example, we need to find the general solution of this differential equation. Again, this differential equation is a linear differential equation of the second order with constant coefficient. And to find the general solution of this differential equation, we need to solve firstly the characteristic equation. So the corresponding characteristic equation will be lambda squared plus 2 lambda plus 10 equals to 0. And we need to find the roots of this quadratic equation. So we will have lambda equal minus 2 plus minus 4 minus 4 times 10 divided by 2. And this is just minus 2 plus minus square root of minus 36 divided by 2. And this is minus 2 plus minus 6i divided by 2. And therefore, our roots will be, the first root will be minus 1 plus 3i, and the second root will be minus 1 minus 3i. So we have solved the characteristic equation for this differential equation, and now we can write the general solution. The general solution for this homogeneous equation will be, so it is constant a, e to the power real part of our roots, it is minus x, then cosine, the imaginary part of our root, it will be 3x, and the second part will be another constant b, exponent to the same power, and now sine of 3x. And this is the general solution of this differential equation.